Hello friends, today I would be unboxing Intel i5-8400 and also compare it with previous gen Intel processor. Currently we can say Intel i5 is the best processor by Intel in market, whose price is fit for almost all PC, budget gaming PC or even professional multitasking PC. Even Intel i3 is a better pick, but when doing multitasking in i3 or while playing heavy games in Intel i3, you may feel little glitches or you may feel little bit slower sometimes. Whereas if you talk about Intel i7 8th gen processor, you won't find much difference in performance unless you're thinking to add multiple peripherals like multiple graphic card or other peripheral devices. Intel i7 8th gen will easily handle multiple graphic card, while Intel i5 8th gen won't be able to give the same result as Intel i7. So if you're thinking to use single graphic card, then Intel i5-8400 is best option for you to pick. Currently you can say this is the best Intel processor for gaming. But if you won't be adding graphic card, if you want to save money by not buying graphic card, then it is recommended for you to go for AMD processor. On this graph, you can clearly see Intel i5-8400 performs best. Now, even you can say Intel i5-8400 is equivalent to previously i7 processors. So this graph is clear. Even if you compare it present 8th gen Intel processor with i3, i5 and i7, you may see like few times even i5 performed better than i7. This is because currently gaming, or there are many devices, many applications which are not designed to use multi-core, multi-thread. That's why the result is, you may see result is almost similar. And so this graph defines everything. Now if you see both of this Intel i7, i3 and i5, all they're using similar graphic cards. So this is the result we got. So if you're thinking to build a budget PC, then this is the best option to pick. Even i3 is recommended if you want to save a little more money, but i7 is not recommended as you won't have drastic improvement. Not like previously we used to have a much higher difference between. Previously if you see, there was a great difference between i7 and i5, but currently difference is not that much. We'll be right back. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, please do subscribe and don't forget to press bell icon, and have a nice day.